It's a pleasure being here, and I am going to speak today on the benefits and challenges and adoption of EHR, HIMS for teaching institutions. Now, by the previous speakers, we have been introduced to the concept of and the utilization of electronic health records, real world implications, and all the future that holds for digital technologies. So I'm going to be limiting myself to what are some of the advantages and what are the challenges you face if these EMR or HISs are implemented in training institutions. Now, before I get there, I'm not really aware of the average age of some of the participants here, but if you are this side of 30, then you will probably not even relate to some of the pictures that I'm showing here. You know, making a long distance call as far back as about 20 years ago was a nightmare. Booking a train ticket, anybody who is studying in a medical college or an engineering college and wanted to go home for vacations would probably be familiar with something like this, you know, getting up, standing in a queue at 5 in the morning only to be told that, you know, the seats have been filled. As far back as a few years ago, we were all standing at the bank trying to get, you know, our check cashed. Now, none of this is sort of relatable because these industries, these interactions have been fundamentally transformed. But these scenes must be very familiar to all the doctors who are here in the audience. Someone scribbling an illegible prescription on a piece of paper, and residents struggling with reams of medical information. Anyone of you who's a resident would be very familiar with the scene that being sent to the MRD is like a punishment, trying to find the medical record of a patient or somebody who has been discharged or trying to complete, you know, an incomplete file, or for your thesis, trying to retrieve some data from these files is nothing less than a nightmare. The plight of trying to sift through medical data in the large MRD departments of every hospital, every teaching institution is very familiar. And the point that I'm trying to make is that use of information technology has fundamentally transformed every industry, except probably healthcare. So now you don't need to go to a bank to transact to be able to exchange money. You don't need to go to a railway station to be able to book your ticket. You don't need to go to an airline's office to be able to book a ticket from Germany to San Francisco. You can do that sitting in the comfort and convenience of your home. But the transactions, the interactions in healthcare industry, unfortunately, seem to be stuck in some kind of a time bomb. And the problem is that we doctors and the whole ecosystem is at a great disadvantage because of this. It's not that doctors are not suffering because of it or the patients are not at a disadvantage. I think the whole industry is at a disadvantage because of lack of adoption IT in our fundamental processes. Lot of doctors that I speak to, they say, oh yeah, well, we are very techno-savvy and we use technology and I have a copy, you know, I have an image of every prescription I write, I take a picture and we use WhatsApp to talk to our patients and, you know, we are using digital technologies. But please understand that while hospitals are one of the most data-intensive environments, unless we are able to store data in a manner that it can be categorized, analyzed, and we analyze that data, the value of that data remains locked forever. And it is for these reasons that we require health information systems and electronic medical records in our institutions. Now, what are the benefits of medical records? The first and foremost is to be able to provide accurate, up-to-date, complete information at the point of care. Wherever you are delivering care to the patient, whether it is in the OPD or in the IPD or in the ICU, you have access to all the relevant information related to that particular patient at that time. Now that more and more chronic illnesses are being there in our population, the requirement for coordination for various clinicians with various departments is rapidly increasing. An EMR or an HIS will help you get quicker access to this. You can securely share electronic information with patients. These days, patients want to know what is happening to them, what is it that you're doing, what are the prescriptions, what are their reports. These systems will help you engage your patients in a much better manner. And the integration of HISs and EMRs with, you know, drug formulations, etc., will give you much better ability to reduce medical errors, to be able to diagnose your patients better, and overall provide a safer care. One of the previous, Dr. Chitale, he had mentioned the rapid rate at which technology and the medical literature is growing. It is humanly not possible to be able to just read up and remember all of this. These electronic systems can bring the cutting edge, the most recent developments in our area to be used for the patient that I'm currently seeing. These digital technologies, if used in our fundamental processes, can enable us to utilize all the technological advancement in the medical sciences that is happening. Now, the question is why HMIS or EMR are important for teaching institutions. My submission is that whatever we learn as medical students, we remember that and we follow that for the rest of our lives. The way we are taught to examine a patient, to, you know, percuss a lung or to, you know, palpate a liver or to do a certain type of, you know, staining of slides, those processes, that learning in a medical institution stays us for the rest of our life as clinicians. And therefore, it is vitally important. You see, corporate hospitals, many corporate hospitals have now HISAs, some even have electronic medical records. But unless this is made available to training institutions where students are doing their MBBSs and their MD/MS residencies, they will not become what are known as digital natives. And as the previous speakers mentioned, you know, these students now are accessing YouTube and WhatsApp and Facebook, and they are very well versed with digital technologies. If what they're studying and if what they're experiencing at bedside can be made available to them with the help of these technologies, these students will take all this with them for the rest of their life and will enrich not only the institution themselves, but the larger society. Now, what are the benefits? The first and foremost benefit of using these digital systems would be for teaching of clinical students. In the current world, if you will see, trying to get hold of a patient's thick file, getting the relevant information out of it for teaching the student's bedside is nearly impossible. A good EMR system will make all that information relevant to be shared with medical students. They can understand it and you can have a much more meaningful discussion. Data for their thesis. Anything that has to be manually retrieved from an MRD on a piece of paper, we all keep saying, oh, my thesis, you know, couldn't get converted into a nice paper and would have been great if we could do it. I have recently helped the National Board of Examination, if any of you are DNB students who probably are using that system, I've helped them create an online logbook. That logbook, you, every procedure you do, you simply just record that in the logbook. Click of a button, you can export all that data into an Excel. It is with you forever. You can analyze it in any which way. And if you wanted to extend that system, you can actually have a long-term follow-up with, you know, some of your patients who can keep providing you periodic data to see how your procedures have impacted their lives. So data for medical research, creating evidence-based protocols, all these things can be utilized if we deploy some of these good electronic systems. The other aspect is running the hospital. Teaching for hospital administration students. Hospitals hold some of the most diverse inventory, implants and consumables and bandages and medicines and so many. The right amount of inventory, what is available, what is not, what is going to expire, what is getting wasted, all these can be managed to a great extent if we are using digital technologies. The same holds true for managing costly equipment for various assets, seeing the performance of the staff, seeing how much time operations are taking, what are the utilization of our operation theaters, all these can be done at a fraction of effort if these digital systems are in place. What are some of the skills that you would require? Implementing an EMR is one of the most complex endeavors that a hospital undertakes. So a good project manager is very, very important. Change management. As I said, healthcare is one of the most resistant industries to change, because doctors for some reason think that, they are the center of the universe. Everything else around them should change, but not them. So managing the change, as the previous speaker said, 5 years ago, there was resistance to say, start using digital data. Now it has become easier. Managing that change, finding champions in your institution who can showcase what they're doing with digital adoption will make a great difference. You need techno-functional experts who understand a bit of IT, bit of healthcare, to be able to help the deployment properly. What are the challenges? Of course, there's a cost of implementation, because there's no hardware, there's no server, networks. You will require laptops or computer on wheels at the bedside. You can't have people have HIS in the hospitals, which is in the nursing station. So when you are at the bedside, you don't have access to the information. And then, it is really very, very poorly utilized. Of course, there is staff resistance. Writing on a piece of paper and then just going off is probably the easiest thing to do. So staff is going to be resistant to that change. Training is time consuming. Doctors are busy, nurses are busy, the technicians are busy. Everybody is overloaded with the work they're already doing. So training for this is going to be time consuming. And the challenge rises that if the workflow in which we see patients or operate or do our work is not exactly kind of mirrored in the HIS, then there is a dissonance that's created, and then that creates a challenge. And of course, people have concern about data privacy. If you have legacy data in your hospital, which is in paper, of course, it is difficult to migrate all that data. Or if the data is in different systems, migrating into one platform is a challenge. Limitation of technical resources. Hospitals are not IT companies. They are not IT factories. So finding technical resources is often a challenge for training institutions. Interoperability. One department has one system. You have an HIS, which is different, an electronic medical record, which is different. They don't talk to each other, and both of them don't talk to the patient portal. So interoperability is challenging. Lack of planning, communication. These are all the challenges that are there if you are implementing EMR in this. But before I close, I just want to say one thing. If we do not use these digital technologies, the world around us is going to change. Right now, doctors and medical students are the center of the universe of patient, providing patient. Now see what has happened. What happened to banks? Paytm has taken away all the payment related transactions away from the banks. Now that thing is gone from them forever. From the airlines, the ticketing has gone. Something similar is already happening in healthcare. There are e-pharmacies which will provide you the dosage and the drug interactions and when did you take the last pill. That intelligence, that analysis, somebody is going to offer. Now, if you see the lab reports that come out, they already offer information on all the parameters. They've already started showing the previous trends of bilirubin and LFT and KFT in the lab reports that they already provide. If we do not adopt, embrace these digital technologies wholeheartedly, we don't use the data analytics in them and offer to the patient, newer startups will nibble away at the periphery, and we will rather, from this being center of offering patient care, we are at the risk of moving to the periphery of this. We will be one among many, and that is already happening. So I would urge all of you to not think that whatever the hell happens, I will always be the most important person in this ecosystem. That is changing very, very fast. And we have a great opportunity to teach our medical students to embrace these technologies and offer all that is available to the patients there. And I want to just close with this quote from Lewis Carroll. This is a 150 years old book, by the way, Alice in Wonderland. My dear, here we must run as fast as we can just to stay in place. And if you wish to go anywhere else, you must run twice as fast as that. The world around us is changing just far too fast. We all have to keep reading and updating ourselves just to be able to answer the patient's queries, which they bring, searching on Google. If we do not embrace these technologies to our benefit, if the institutions keep sort of burying their head in the sand saying, will stick to paper and will stick to taking photo copies and using Excel sheets, we run the risk of being left behind almost irretrievably. I would once again thanks the organizers for giving me the opportunity to give this talk. If somebody has any questions, I'll be very happy to answer. Thank you so much.